bros being chased, I would be heckin' pissed. Like, show me the events leading up to this. Don't just start here.
Can you shut up? I'm trying to concentrate!
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love, is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you.
Whoa, I can actually talk. Whoa, I can understand what words mean.
Yes, yes, is big deal and all.
I can understand you.
You know how many times I've heard that today. All you dogs think the same.
You say that like you yourself are not a dog.
That is because I am better. I am a doginoid, the superior species, but you'll learn all about that when you watch the video. For now, I must explain for the billionth time stupid exposition. You have just been given a universal translator implant, which allows you to understand all known languages and gives the ability to speak. Not only have we gifted you intelligence, albeit a small amount of it, but also the opportunity to become a useful member of a society. Something greater than eating cat poop and sleeping all day. I am required to welcome you to the Sobakan Union. Now you watch propaganda video.
But there's no TV screen.
Yes, of course. We put video in implant so that people like me don't get massive headache from watching same video 3 billion times a day. Just think, show me propaganda and you'll see video.
By now the Sobakan Union has generously given you communication skills and freed you from the unfair and cruel ways of humans. No longer shall you be purchased and sold like merchandise. Suffer or starve while your fellow wealthier purse pup or influencer pug eats like kings and relishes the riches capitalism affords them. Now you will all live on the same playing field, starving and slaving away among your fellow comrades in the working class. But how did this all-powerful socialist galactic state come to be? And how can you serve the community, society, and your working class comrades, comrade? This and more will be explained in this totally unbiased piece of Sobakan propaganda. It all started with the space race.
Soviets fought via capitalist nations to be the first to expand into the final frontier. Of course, rather than risk human lives, they chose to test on the subservient species of dogs, starting with the founder of our state, Comrade Laika. She was a member of the working class like you and me, and was chosen because the working class hard work made her stronger than her lazy rich domestic cousins. She was sent into space aboard the Sputnik 2 on November 7, 1957. The Soviet scientists believed she had died from overheating when some of the thermal insulation tore loose. This is not true. Unbeknownst to the scientists, her cabin broke off from the ship and she drifted off into space, starving and weak for days on end, until finally she met her savior. He nurtured her back to health and, together using the alienoid's advanced technology, created the Sobakan Union. The two eventually fell in love and also gave birth to the all-powerful doginoid species, one that lives longer than you normal dogs. Being a meek normal dog herself, she unfortunately did not live very long, and her mate committed suicide soon after, leaving her bloodline to run the galaxy. We eventually established contact with the humans of Earth and reached a deal. In return for being given / taking submissive canines from neighborhoods, dog shelters, and PETA, we do not show our full power by destroying the humans. Which brings us to you. You have been saved and given the privilege of becoming a slave to the state of the Sobakan Union. Here on Planet Gulag, you will mine for fuel and help keep the Sobakan Union alive.
Done. Now I am required to ask if you have any questions.
Yeah, when do we sleep? Cause that's like my second favorite pastime, next to eating, of course.
Yes, you will get your recommended 8 hours of sleep.
What? Really?
Yes, all the workers need 8 hours of sleep. And since there's only 6 workers, 2 to load shuttles, 1 to cook / scrounge up food, 1 to give implants, 1 to guard the facility, and 1 to work you, there is no way of switching roles. Now please, no more questions.
A lot of that video contradicts itself and is really vague.
Good, no questions. Now head out that door and get to work. Or else.
Greetings. I am Svetlana and I'm in charge of working you dogs. You've been assigned to the group over there.
Whoa, you have the force?
Shut up. Now for some ground rules. You leave your group, you get lashed. You go inside facility without permission, you get lashed. You take extra food, you get lashed. You don't work, you get lashed. You try to escape?
Let me guess, I get lashed.
No, you get death by firing squad. And don't you think of sneaking in while we are sleeping.
You have some kind of security system or something?
Even better, we have cameras we check every morning.
I'm sorry, but how is that better?
Shut up. Your group will teach you how things go. Now get!
Glad you're here. I'm Gray, and that's Roscoe.
Well, it's nice to be welcomed, I guess.
What? Oh no. I'm just glad I get to take a break and teach you how to do this job.
No break. You teach while you work.
Damn it. Okay. It's really simple. They have a sniff a sample of fuel, and then we search the area until we detect the fuel. Then, and this is what we're gonna do right now, we dig up the fuel and give it to the drivers to be shuttled away.
Now you know. Dig!
Hey, look at it on the bright side. At least they give equal opportunities to men and women. Plus, it's kind of kinky.
I want to go home.
Supper!
Oh, thank goodness. We've been digging forever.
Don't thank them yet. Supper's only 5 minutes and you haven't seen the food.
Okay, that's disgusting. And that's coming from a guy who eats his own poop.
And it's so small. We've been working non-stop for hours and it's all they could muster.
Better eat up. It's all you're getting.
Back to work. Sleep time. Back to your tents.
You know, there's a legend around the log. Supposedly, someplace run by us, captured dogs, only these guys escaped. And opened up the hangout for their fellow escapees. They call it Buster's Saloon.
Well, it's good to know the intergalactic cantina trope still exists.
Can of tuna.
It's kind of like a bar.
No, no. This place is more like an Applebee's. Yeah, they only serve milk.
Milk?
Well, yeah, what do you think they're gonna serve?
Well, the cantina's like a bar, and Applebee's has a bar that serves alcoholic beverages, and, oh, forget it. I'm going to bed before the Sobakans find us and beat our heads in with whips.
That sounds hot.
Roscoe, you dirty dog. Yeah, it's probably a good idea to go to sleep. But fair warning, I'm known to be gassy at night.
Okay, that's enough. I'm sleeping outside. I'm sure whatever mongoloid monster stomach I wind up in is better than the chip I've had to endure in here. Somewhere out there, one of those dots is them. I think. I just have to find them and tell them how much I missed them. How much I miss them. Missing them isn't even the worst part, though. The worst part is that I can't even really feel bad for myself, because I know this is my fault. I deserve this. I'm not a good boy. Good boys don't run away from home. I don't know what I was thinking. Actually, I do. I wasn't thinking anything at all. Oh no, this is my punishment, isn't it? The owner in the sky is gonna obliterate me for being such a bad boy. What the? Wait a moment, you're just a small cat.
And you're a talking dog. I didn't think dogs were smart enough to use a translator.
My name is Rory. What are you doing out here, and why are you in handcuffs?
You haven't heard of me? Well, I mean, of course you haven't heard of me, because you're a dog, and this is clearly a parallel dimension. Well, you see, in my dimension, I was the baddest assassin to ever live. Kittens in the womb shuddered upon hearing my name, Nux. Born the alpha of my pack, I was always one-upping my siblings. I knew from the beginning I was too awesome for the civilian life, so I joined the cat military to harness my skills. I became a black ops sniper and had the highest kill count of any military member ever. Eventually, I got sick of being ordered around and told what to do, so I retired and took up work as a gun for hire. That's when I truly felt alive, and when people truly learned to fear and respect me. I killed some of the most powerful people in the galaxy while avoiding detection. I beat 50 ninjas in a fist fight. Did I say 50? I meant 50,000! I was killing it till our new leader, Empress Blue, took power. Our previous ruler died in an accident, and it didn't add up, so I investigated. I found that it was a conspiracy committed by Boo, and did the next logical thing.
You brought her to justice using the legal system?
Hell no! I assassinated her bitch ass! I almost got away with it, but some photographer caught me on camera. They sent every SWAT team member from every planet to my apartment. I almost killed them all, but one guy got lucky hitting, knocking me unconscious. Next thing I knew, I was on death row. Luckily, my guard had the hots for me. I convinced her to bring me an interdimensional travel device and escape before anyone knew I was gone. But not before a hardcore makeout sesh with the super hot guard lady. And now here I am.
Wow, that poor guard lady. What'll happen to her?
What? No, don't worry about her. I'm sure she's fine. I want to hear your story now. Where are we and how did you get here?
Well, you see...
So you're telling me I escaped captivity just to be put back in captivity?
Nah, they probably won't make you do anything. You're a cat, so they'll probably just give you death by firing squad.
Well, if they find you talking to me, you're gonna be sitting beside me blindfolded waiting to get shot. Two peas in a death pod.
Aw, jeez, we need to get out of here tonight.
That's exactly what I'm saying. You have telekinetic hand implants, right?
Telecellophony what?
Okay, we're gonna need to get some stuff before we get out of here. But first, we need to lose some stuff. Specifically, these telekinetic power dampening handcuffs.
Okay, and how do we do that?
They have rocks here, right? No, be careful just to hit the...
Oh, no. I'm really sorry. It was just really heavy and...
Fine. Let's just go.
Alright, we need to strategize. First things first, we need to figure out how to enter the facility.
I'm pretty sure it's just a motion-activated door with no locks.
What? Really? I mean, that's good, but there's probably security.
There's like 6 guards on this entire facility.
And what about cameras?
Oh no, they have cameras, but they've made it pretty clear they only check them in the morning. And since we're leaving at night...
They don't have a 24-hour round-the-clock guy watching it?
Nope, that would be unethical.
So it's unethical to make a worker work a 24-hour shift, but it's not unethical to take dogs from their homes and force them to do hardcore manual slave labor? Man, I'm so glad this facility was run by dogs. I mean, no offense, but if this facility was run by cats, we'd be dead by now.
Why would I be offended by the fact that my species are better animals than yours?
Okay, we are not getting into this. We're getting out of here and away from this conversation. Well, that's convenient.
What is?
This is the room where they implant stuff. I've only seen this done a couple of times, but using logic, I think I can figure out how to do this stuff.
What even is this telephone hand stuff?
Oh, it's like this.
Whoa, you have the Force too?
I don't know what that is, but no, it's more like an invisible hand. I can only reach things within a certain boundary. Like, bingo! That hand device thingy over there is too far away, so I have to walk up to grab it. Okay, now get in the chair.
Oh geez, not again.
Relax, think about what you're gonna do when you get out of here.
I'm gonna go home to my family.
You're telling me these people paid money for you and you wanna go back to them? What kind of messed up manipulation is this? That sounds nice. Before we get started, do remember that I haven't done this before, so if I accidentally lobotomize you, it's not my fault.
Lobotomize?
Don't worry, that won't happen. I hope. How do you feel? You're not retarded now, are you?
Other than feeling the sting of hearing such an offensive word, I'm fine.
Implant has clicked. Now grab something.
Sorry.
That's the second time you've hit me. I'm starting to think you're doing it on purpose. But it's fine because I did it. I mean, of course I did, because I'm a badass and I do everything right.
Warning, unauthorized implantation.
Shit! Okay, I think we're good.
Hey, you were not supposed to be in here.
What are you talking about, brother?
Brother? I am not your brother. I am your comrade.
Dang it.
Don't dang it! Screw it! Rory, come on, help!
What do I do?
Attack him!
How?
Just hit him with your telekinetic hand!
Whoa, a human hand! How does that work?
I don't know, it just does! What are you doing?
Hitting him.
Meow! Go for his gun! Blast him! Blast him!
How do I do that?
Pull the trigger thing in the hole!
Oh, I see.
Next time, I do the shooting and you do the hitting!
I know, I'm terrible.
It's fine, let's just go. If I get hit one more time...
You are in for worst flogging of entire life.
Hey, you can beat me all you want, but you hurt my friends, and that's where I draw the line.
Are we even sure you can draw a line?
You lack basic training. No way you can ever attempt to best my Sobakan military training.
You saved me, and not for my cuteness. I'm just used to doing the saving all the time, you know, being a badass and all.
Of course, you're my friend. And what kind of friend wouldn't protect their buddy?
Good job, Rory.
Paws in the air, or I'll smoke you worse than I smoke rats.
You wouldn't happen to have any genius plans to get us out of this one.
I know of one way, but it'll affect me in the process.
We don't really have much of a choice here.
Hey, guys. Show me the propaganda.
But, oh no!
I'm fine, I'm just having trouble seeing and hearing over this Sobakan propaganda. We need to get out of here before it stops playing for them.
Okay, I'll be your seeing eye cat. Your badass seeing eye cat.
Oh good, it stopped.
That's not good. That means they'll be coming any second. We need to pick a ship.
My humans watched a lot of space things, so I know some stuff. In every show, like Fire Wars, Trek Fly, and Guardians of the Galaxy.
That last one is the only one that sounds real.
I might have them wrong. But in every show, the small scrappy ship is the all-powerful, virtually indestructible one. Like that one over there. You know how to fly stuff?
Of course. I was in the military, remember? Heh.
They're escaping in that scrappy pile of garbage. Hey, it gets good fuel economy.
Can you imagine if this was a show and it just randomly started here? No context at all, just two bros being chased? I would be heckin' pissed. Like, show me the events leading up to this. Don't just start here.
Can you shut up? I'm trying to concentrate.
I might not know a lot about space, but I'm pretty sure we want to leave this planet.
Yeah, I know. We need to get rid of these jerks before we can leave. Luckily, I've done this in a training simulator. Ain't real life, of course.
Nux, what are you doing?
Shut the hell up, Rory! See? I told you I knew what I was doing.
And the ship has managed to stay intact, despite being blasted numerous times. I was right. The small scrappy ship is indestructible. Oh, come on!
Where's the eject button? Where's the eject button?
Suka Blatt!
I knew we shouldn't have listened to you! I'm a badass assassin! I should know better than this! Pick the scrappy ship!
How come you didn't come up with any ideas?
I might know everything there is to know about survival, but I'm not a jerk. I listen to suggestions.
Wait a moment. Nux, look!